Everybody, it's Dr. Kate Walker. Welcome to October 22nd, Thursday 30. I don't know, it's a really weird day for me. It's sort of one of those days where, okay, how many more days can it be humid? How many more days can it be foggy? It's October, so I light my October candles. You know, I'm trying to get into the spirit of the holidays, but I know for a lot of us, this can actually be kind of a doldrums time. And so it's interesting because as a family systems person and as a professional counselor, I always look at things like, okay, what is the calendar showing me? And the calendar sometimes gives away the things that are kind of underlying here. And what I notice is as the mom of three kids, October is when progress reports came out. Y'all, that wasn't always a good time at the Walker household. So I'm noticing what's going on inside of me. And what do I do when I've got to push through this stuff? Well, I want to get creative. We had an amazing comment in our last Thursday 30, and someone asked, hey, can we get some creative ideas for our interns to gain hours? And I thought, okay, yeah, we can do that. How does that work in with our theme and level one and leveling up? I got it. So today we're going to talk about leveling up as a brand new intern slash associate. And we're going to talk about those of us who are ready to add a niche to our existing business to get us on the path of being happy, maybe happier, and of course, making more money. So, but first things first, I got to do some shout outs. We have, I don't even know, how many badasses do we have this week? We have so many new badasses. So y'all give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down if I am not live or if something's going on with my video. Come on. Show me if I'm live. All right, I don't see me. So maybe, let's see. It says I'm live. All right, I'm gonna trust it. I'm gonna trust the process. All right, so here are the new badasses this week. Welcome to the badass group. Dana Futrell, Jessica Villegas, Veronica Cabadaguerro, Marita Benavides, Jessica Esmus Rogers, Christy Hamm, Shield Bearer Counseling Center. So glad that you're here. Oh yeah, thanks y'all, appreciate that. Amy Smith Drury, Lee Kirby, Victoria Hamilton, and Summer Grace Danner. I am so glad you guys are here. And you know what? I know a few of you are actually my students. This semester has been so cool for me because I'm getting to teach at two universities. I teach at the University of Houston Victoria campus and the University of Texas El Paso campus. And I'm so glad you guys are here. It's so neat to see you guys joining and getting a jump on your career. So welcome. Tell your friends. Come on, bring it. So as you know, I love to do free things like my YouTube channel of this Thursday 30, my two Facebook groups, my communities for supervisors, and my community for badasses like you. But it's the paid stuff that pays the bills, so I got to do a few commercials. Before I get going on the commercials, though, I will tell you what I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to talk about those of us who are in, I lovingly like to call, the second half of life, and we're struggling with identity, okay, and what that means. Well, that is a beautiful place to be when you're building a niche, all right? But not only that, I'm going to talk to you first career folks. You went bachelor's degree, master's degree, boom, and you're in your profession. You're about to start your 3,000 hours. Maybe you're in the middle of your 3,000 hours, and you're thinking, okay, I hear everybody talk about niche. What does that mean? Or niche, like I like to call it. What does that mean? What does that mean for my business? What does that mean for my pocketbook? What does that mean for my balanced life? And it's so important that you have a balanced life, that you're doing what you love to do. You newbies, you're going to be doing some work in your 3,000 hours that I lovingly call grunt work, right? It's not a quality experience. They aren't great hours, but you're putting in the time to get the 3,000 hours you need to be licensed. While you're doing that, you can think about what you need to do in order to finally have your dream job. That's what I'm going to talk about. But first, the commercials. Did you know that I am the designer and provider of the completely online 40-hour training for dual-licensed LPC and LMFT? Or if you're just an LPC or just an LMFT and you want to get the supervisor designation for either one, I got you covered. We have a 90-day course. 90 days because LPC, that's what they say, that's what we do. We can only give you 90 days to complete the course. And at the end of that 90 days, you can submit this continuing education to become a supervisor in Texas. And we have had I want to say almost 100 graduates since we started this in April 2019, the completely online version. It's a good course, y'all. And of course, you know, I'm going to give you a community when you come out the other side. I'm not going to leave you hanging. So tell a friend. If you're a supervisor, as soon as this ends, you know the drill. Go over to Texas Supervisor Training and join. That will be your comfy, cozy, soft place to land your supervisors who will come with you and be with you while you ask great questions. Also, we have our monthly consultation group this Monday, October 26th at 8 a.m. We're welcoming LPC Supervisor and LPC Board Member Janie Stubblefield. She's going to talk to us about things like, what do supervisors get in trouble for? What are the things she's seeing as far as complaints? And ethics and future trends. We have had so many changes. I don't need to tell you guys, right? So many changes. And she's going to help us know maybe a little bit about what's on the horizon. If you can't join us in October, join us in November, because Blaine Hummel will come and talk to us about how we are all pulling our hair out, or many of us are, over the 1099 versus W-2 thing. All right. Then I need to let you know, I'm presenting a refresher course just for supervisors as a pre-conference workshop at the Texas Counseling Association Professional Growth Conference. That's a mouthful. In November. So I will be doing that Wednesday, November 11th from 8:45 to 5 p.m. It's 6.5 hours CEs for supervision and ethics. You've got to sign up for the Professional Growth Conference to do that. I think it's a little bit extra in order to do the pre-conference, but it's completely worth it. Thanks for the shout out, Mark. I appreciate it. Thank you. And I will be presenting with rock star Cindy Doyle, building a badass business, embracing your unique counselor identity. We'll be doing that at the Professional Growth Conference. And I'm going to be featured on Julia A. Rose 2020 Farewell 2020 goal tour. And I'm going to be presenting goal setting and self-care, our friends, time management, grow your business and save your life. This will be coming, I think it's December the 4th. I'll have more information about that coming soon. And last but not least, you know, I don't talk about breast cancer a lot in October. I don't know why, but I don't. Well, I call it baby breast cancer, right? So baby breast cancer was my friend back in 2005 when I was going through my PhD program. I had 3 little kids. I had a husband in Iraq, and I did not have time for chemo and radiation. So I chose double mastectomy. And a lot of you notice that I have tattoos. Well, I finally made a video cataloging the journey of reconstruction and what happened with my reconstruction, why I chose reconstruction, what happened, the aftermath. You know, breast cancer for women isn't just about the tumor. It's about a part of your body perhaps being chopped off. I mean, it's part of who you are. It's an erogenous zone. It's so many things. And it ties into a lot of what we're talking about now, our identity. So if I get the courage, I'm going to release that video next week so you can see my journey as I went through reconstruction. Remember, the cancer for me wasn't a problem, right? It was a baby tumor. My life was never in danger, as far as I know. The reconstruction, on the other hand, that was hell. And I know a lot of women, you go through that in order to reclaim your identity. So if I have the courage, I'll release it next week in honor of breast cancer, because you know what? I'm sick of this shit. Let's cure breast cancer. Let's quit cutting things off. Let's just cure it. All right, moving on. Who wants me to review their website? Post a link in the thread and I will be happy to review your website on our next week's Thursday 30. All right, let's get into the meat of this stuff. Everybody gets to be level one. Everybody, right? And if you watch, listen, read Malcolm Gladwell, there's this idea that somehow 10,000 hours makes you an expert. It's kind of baloney, but we'll go with that, right? So think of anything you've done. If you've reached my age, if you are about to be 54 years old, you've probably experted a couple of things. And there's a feeling of competency, almost fluency, right? So if you are able to manage, if you're fluent in another language, you know, there comes a time when it's just second nature. You don't think about it. If you play a musical instrument, you know, there comes a time when you don't think about it. You just do it. So the older we get, inevitably will put 10,000 hours into something, right? groups like mine, we try to get you to put the 10,000 hours into things that will actually grow your business, right? Not 10,000 hours on Facebook or 10,000 hours, you know, watching TV. 10,000 hours focused on something positive will supposedly result in some mastery of a topic. Now, that's a complicated issue. Yes, it has to be, you know, perfect practice makes perfect, but I'm not getting into that. But here's where I stand. When you start something new, you're going to be level one. Level one mistakes are expensive. And so let's not be surprised by that. Let's go ahead and budget for that. So I'm going to talk about as far as when you are in this second career part of life. One of the things that happens is this natural transition, right? Your kids are going to launch, or if you didn't have kids, you're still getting into the second part of life where, okay, what do I want to do? What do I want to be? And it feels weird because it's almost like that feeling when you're 18 years old and you're about to go off to college, except you're not going off to college and hopefully you're not leaving home. So you're home, you're thinking, all right, I've got the bills paid, the house is clean, now what? This is when we release our inner eight-year-old. Your inner eight-year-old wanted to be a ballerina in space with a football, right? She wanted everything. He wanted to be a quarterback, ballerina, fireman. I don't know. There was this eight-year-old inside of you that wanted to be everything. Well, with your business, that can be amazing, but we've talked before, you got to get everything else in place first. And if you didn't remember that, scroll back down, go to the Thursday 30 when we talked about, should you add something new to your business? How do you know when it's time to add something new to your business? This week, it's all about how to get that experience. So I know I talk a lot in this group about folks who have added things to their business, but they have to answer things like, who am I and what do I want? Here's why, because you have to develop a brand. Your brand has to represent who you are and what you're selling, right? So if you add yoga to your practice, what does your Instagram feed look like? What does your logo look like? Do you have tattoos? What color is your hair? What do you wear? Do you have a particular color that you like? Remember when you were a teenager? I know when I was a teenager, there was the group that wore black all the time. There was the group that always went outside at lunch to smoke. Yes, when I was a teenager, we were allowed to smoke on campus, or those other people were. Right, there were the jocks, there were the cheerleaders, there were the, right, it's like the Breakfast Club. Everybody is known by something. Well, at this second part of life, you can do that too. I yesterday had posted in the Austin Mental Health group, I want to know about walk talk therapy, right? Not for me, but for my intern. Tell me about it. Have coffee with me. Explain how this works. I want to help my supervisee get proficient at walk talk therapy. So I get to learn about it too. Now, will I do it someday? I don't know. Right now, I'm deciding who I am in this second half of life, right? My kids are adults. My husband and I, we've got our bills paid. So it's time to see, okay, what else can I add? It's time to start dreaming. It's time to make that vision board again. You remember that thing? Time to dust it off, get it out, tear off the old pictures, and put on some new ones that really fit for you. Last week, I posted a video about a new tent that I bought. It's one of those that just kind of pops out, and there it is. Now your tent. I'm going to go try tent camping. Y'all, 20 years ago, I swore I would never go tent camping. I have an RV in my driveway. I'm going to try it though, right? Because I'm trying to release my inner eight-year-old that says, ah, yes, I'm going to go do that. Say yes. You've got to experience new things before you incorporate them into your business, because remember what I said last week, incorporating them into your business is going to be expensive. You will make mistakes. You're going to have some kind of a reworking of your website, your logo, your Instagram feed, your Facebook, your social media, how you project to your audience, your customers, who you are and what you're selling. So, level three, expertise, right? We know you're here, right? You're in your second half of life. You're good at something. That's the key. You're not starting this out as a rank newbie. You have expertise. Maybe you already do know how to speak another language and play an instrument and do all those things. We know you got a master's degree. Some of you have a PhD. That says you're an expert. Hopefully you have over 10,000 hours of counseling. You are good at what you do. It's a great time to add something new to your profession. Dare to be level one again. Dare to dream again. Put up the dang poster board. Get your vision board out there. Put up whatever it is you see yourself that 5 years from now you is going to shake your hand and thank you for. And let's start dreaming again. Now, I want to talk to you newbies, right? I want to talk to you grad students. I want to talk to you because you think this is it. This is the end of the road. You've gotten the student loans. You got your master's degree. Time to go lock myself in this itty bitty room for 20 hours a week and counsel. I'm going to counsel. Well, y'all, if you do that for 20 years, you're going to get burned out. It's going to affect your balance. It's going to affect your life balance. You have coffee. You set meetings with anybody in this group. I dare you. And they will tell you, you cannot just counsel 20 direct hours a week as a licensed professional counselor, licensed LMSW, MFT, psychologist. You cannot just sit for 20 hours in a room with someone else for 20 years and be okay. So this is a great place. This Badass Business Group is an amazing place for you to start looking at the things other people are doing, right? We've got somebody in this group with an alpaca farm, and she has alpacas as support animals for people. We've got people in this group doing equine therapy. We have people in this group, of course, I've mentioned before, doing yoga and walk talk therapy. Put in the thread all of the things that you have added successfully to your business so that these newbies, these new folks can see what they can eventually do. So here's the thing, new folks, you're going to be level one, right? When you introduce yourself to your supervisor and you guys sign the paperwork and you start getting direct hours and you're supervising every week, yeah, you're level one. You're going to make some mistakes. You're going to get pissed off at your supervisor. You guys are going to make up. It's going to be fine. Eventually, you will get to be a level three intern, and eventually you will be my colleague. And it will be awesome. And you're going to breathe a huge sigh of relief, and you're going to say, ah, I made it. Now you're level one again, right? You're a brand new, fully licensed mental health professional. Start investigating other things. So, you know, I mentioned all of the kind of non-traditional things like the walk talk therapy and the yoga, et cetera, yada, yada. There's also experiential therapy. We've got a guy in this group, Fred Burrell is in this group, and he does experiential learning and counseling. It's a great way to accrue hours. So if you're interested in these things, talk to your supervisor about it. Say, you know what? I would really like to do some ropes courses. Is there any way that I could pair up with this supervisor over here? Maybe it doesn't have to be formal paperwork, but someone else who can guide you into this other area of counseling. You know, maybe you'll hate it. Maybe you'll get on a ropes course, be afraid of heights, never want to go back. That's okay. At least you gave it a try. Maybe you want to go try, just go see what yoga therapy is about. Go see what it's like to do trauma-informed yoga. It's worth checking into. This is the time for you to do your career counseling search, right? It's time to go try some new things. Interview some people. Buy somebody some virtual coffee. We've got more traditional things, too. If you're an LPC newbie, chances are you have not been fully trained in couple techniques. You know, maybe you've taken a class, right? Even if you're an MFT, you maybe had a 3-hour class, but in your supervision experience, you're just not getting the relational hours. And we know with this new rule incarnation for MFTs, they're actually going to lower the number of relational hours. So you'll be getting less of those hours with more than one person in a room. Go get you some Gottman training. Go get you some Imago training. Go and do some specific training and see if you like it, right? You may do the Imago training and decide, oh my gosh, I hate couples. I didn't like being in the room when my parents were fighting. I don't like being in the room when my couples are fighting. Better to find out now than 10 years down the road and you're like, why am I burned out? Oh, I've been with a population that I really can't stand. So Gottman, EMDR, I always blank on what that means. Somebody put it in the thread for me. E, M as in Mary, D as in David, R, EMDR. It's wonderful. And then there are so many things coming off of that that have to do with trauma-informed therapy. The body keeps the score. If you don't know trauma, you probably aren't counseling right. You know, you've got to get some training, but you could be that informed guy or gal in your town, right? You could be that person who's the expert. So those are more traditional things. If you have specific areas that you're interested in, like play therapy or working with sex offenders, You're going to have to get a supervisor, right? If you want to make it official, and this was a great conversation in our Texas supervisor training group this week. I always love it when this topic comes up. When two supervisors share you, right? You've got two supervisors, they're both signing your paperwork. How many hours a week do you want to meet with each one? Well, That's a question that I love to discuss, and I'll talk about it later. But as you are the one wanting the expertise, why don't you get tons of hours with each one, right? If you really want to be an experiential ropes course facilitator counselor, you know, go spend 8 hours a week with Fred if he's a supervisor. If you want to be an EMDR therapist, don't limit the number of hours you spend with these experts. Spend more. So this is your career. These are your 10,000 hours. And this month is all about how to be okay with being a level one. Embrace your level oneness, right? Embrace the idea that this is the time as a newbie to make the mistakes because you've got a supervisor, right? Those of us in the second half of life, we get supervision too. It's in groups like the Texas Supervisor Training Group, the monthly consultation group, and there are tons of groups out there, even virtually, Facebook, social media, who can surround you and really give you a great place. I found a website last week, Ecotherapists of Texas, something like that. I'll put that in the thread so that you can see. But if you're a supervisor right now and you're trying to think of creative ways to get your intern slash associate some direct hours, just remember, they can get a direct hour if they're presenting and they are the presenter. If they're in a school setting and they're delivering a service, so they're the one delivering the guidance lesson or they're the one delivering a counseling session, right? You don't just get a direct hours because you show up for work every day. But as the supervisor, you get a lot of leeway, right? The rules clearly define on all of our licenses and our scope of practice, the rules clearly define what counseling is, and you can deduce from that what it is not, right? And so you can come up with really creative ways for your interns to get some direct hours in places where they can explore what they want their career to be. Supervisors, does it mean you'll need to stretch a little bit and kind of test your own level oneness? Yeah, probably. But what a great thing to do. It's going to make you a better supervisor. All right, I'm running out of time. So let me summarize today. What I talked about was getting creative with your vision here so you can release your inner 8-year-old, start dreaming again, and adding other niches to your business, not only to give you balance, but to make you some money. I cannot emphasize enough, do your market research. Don't create a niche that you go look and you see, oh my gosh, every church in town offers this service for free. Why in the world would I want to add that to my business when people can go get it for free somewhere else? Now, having said that, I'm sure a lot of you are thinking, yes, but if you're the expert, people will pay money. Well, yeah, of course they will. But do your market research. If it's something unique, if it's something that people are already wanting, if you notice that there's already a market for it, somebody else somewhere is already doing it, do it. Go look, go find out. If it's something brand new, nobody's doing it, nobody's ever done it, caution, right? There may be a reason nobody's doing it, nobody's done it. I know I had a colleague, well, not really a colleague, but I she was in the office building with me, and I walked past, and I knew she was a counselor, and I walked past her office one day, and I saw a massage table. And I was like, hey, what you doing in there? And it was a new modality where she was doing counseling and touch and massage. And that's great. Good on her. And I hope she got trained. I know nothing about that. And so I don't know a lot of people who are doing that. So please put it in the thread if you're doing it. But again, I want to remind you, know the rules, know the law, make sure you're properly trained, make sure you're properly supervised. And check the liability. I know I saw something in our Texas Supervisor training thread this morning. We can't find the folks who've had punishments levied against them in the new BHEC website, right? And that's always a real educational list, so you can see where people have gotten in trouble. You might want to check that list when it comes out to see if people are getting in trouble for things you want to specialize in, right? Danger, danger. So check it out. So this month in October has been all about adding to your practice if you're an existing licensed professional. And for you newbies, it's all about dreaming, letting yourself be happy, and knowing that no one can be happy doing the same thing their whole life, right? You learn that in your lifespan course. We all have to transition. We all have to go through changes. We are all forming our identity all of the time. Just know it's okay to change your mind. Just make sure you're properly trained. If you're a supervisor and your supervisee says, I want to know more about X, Y, and Z, get them some information, but be honest with them. If you don't want to supervise it, don't supervise it. All right, that's it. Look for my video next week if I'm brave enough. And I will see you guys at next week's Thursday 30. Today is October 22nd. I'm Dr. Kate Walker. Thank you guys all for tuning in today. Have a great day.